This week on Angling Archaeology, we're going to put in some hard work with the man's hard worm. Will this lure give us a hard time? Well, stick around and find out. So let's take a hard look at the hardworm. New for 1984, the first introduction I found was in the September/October 1983 issue of Bassmaster magazine. Now, as you can see from this incredible full color spread, that Tom Mann was incredibly proud of this lure. And what's not to love about this early 80s advertising? You've got the hardworm coming in hot though with the action photo, and then Tom Mann there in the background, almost as if it's like an old school Olin Mills photograph. You can see here at the bottom, he said, the only alternative to ordinary crankbaits, the ultimate lure, looks like a worm, fishes like a hard bait, and even comes in my patented fruit flavors, try one. And then you've got a little box over here in the corner where you can cut this out, send in $3, and get yourself a hardworm and a brochure. Now, as we move into the next month's issue of Bassmaster magazine, which would be the November/December 1983 issue, we see another advertising from Tom Mann with the new electrifying colors. And we see right there prominently, front and center, the man's hardworm. Now, Tom Mann claimed he caught over 500 fish while testing out the hardworm, which leads me to believe that he took this lure pretty seriously. Now, moving into the March 1984 Bassmaster magazine, we've got an insert here from Kmart Sports Center. And what we see are two different variations of the man's hardworm. We have the topwater on the left, and we have the medium diver on the right in the chartreuse. Now, the hardworm came in a variety of variations. You had multiple diving, which would be shallow, medium, and deep diving. You had a topwater, and also, probably one of the more rare ones, the sinking model. I would say that the medium diver and the topwater with the prop were likely the most popular because I see them most advertised and in most catalogs. Speaking of Bass Pro catalogs, we've got a 1985 Bass Pro catalog right here with two different variations showing. We have the medium diver and the topwater, and it shows the color chart as well on the right. Also, by the time we get to 1985, that's the end of the road for the hardworm. That's right, folks. The hardworm only lasted 2 years, 1984 and 1985. Although the hardworm had some weak sales in the 1980s, it's got a resurgence now in the collector market and is somewhat a sought-after lure. And funny enough, the hardworm wasn't the only quote-unquote hard plastic worm on the market. That's right, Strike King actually had one called the Bitsy Wiggler. So what are your thoughts? Is it the ultimate lure or a hard pass? All right, so here's a hardworm up close real quick. I mean, as you can see, it really kind of looks like a downsized jerkbait. So let's toss it out there and see how this does. Let me show you the action of this as well. I mean, it's got great wiggle, really nice tight wiggle to it. So you can see that. Let's see if we can get one more here. So, I mean, really pretty cool little lure. Well, I'm beginning to think I know why it was discontinued.
Little guy.
Oh,
it was a bat. Oh, it's a
stick.
Damn it. I hope that was on camera.
Exactly what I was scared of.
Damn it.
Well, there goes this video. All right, so here's what we're using. We've got this kind of medium diver hardworm here that's purple with some silver sparkle in it. And I gotta tell you a little bit of an interesting situation. We're almost in October, it's 95 degrees out, and I've been out here for a while and the fish are just not biting. Nothing. Oh, and they just say that and they get them. Oh, and I just had a bite. So there you go. So as much as I can, I like to fish kind of parallel to the dock. So kind of flip it over like that and then just kind of approach it and come to the side. I think a lot of fish use this as cover. They're probably going to be in these darker shadow areas. Not that I'm any expert, certainly haven't caught anything with this, but I think this will at least improve my chances. Well, when all else fails, just spend $60 on brats. There it is. Oh my gosh. Oh, okay. Oh, that's the first fish I've had on in like five or six times. Oh my gosh, it's coming out here. It's only taken about a month to just get that. Okay, so that's the most action I have literally seen with this lure. I'm sure this would be pretty good at a little farm pond, but at this lake, it's just been a grind. But what I'm doing is I'm letting it sink, you know, reeling it in, letting it sink, let it float to the top like it's doing right now, reel it back down, come to the top, and that fish hit it when it was floating up to the top. So we'll see if I can actually land one. There it is. Yes. Oh, finally. Finally. There it is. I have 1% battery left. Just getting ready to leave. Didn't even get him. Just got him by the gill. There it is. All that for that. Let's get him back. See? Well, that wasn't so hard now, was it? Literally took little to no effort. Well, see, folks, just as easy as that, right? The hardworm didn't give me a hard time. Let's be honest. The hardworm did give me a hard time. But you know what? We had a couple variables we need to think about there. Record high heat, record droughts, super low water levels. And let's not forget the most important thing is that I suck at fishing. Well, I'm not going to discredit the hardworm. You know what? I think there's a time and place for it. If you're looking for a downsized jerkbait, this model in particular would be a great option right here. Has good action in the water. The tail's going to drive them crazy. It's not a bad little lure. So that's going to do it for this episode of Angling Archaeology, where we unearth the good old days. I want to thank you all for watching. If you haven't done so, please like and subscribe. It really helps me out a lot. And hey, if you haven't forgot, got some pretty sweet little merch. Check out the merch shop. Got cool little hats like this, or we even have shirts like this 8-bit bass right above. So thank you all for watching. Until next time, folks, we'll see you on the water.